to LU Swing Club.
Yes.
Week three of our virtual lessons.
Today is a very fun day. We're going to be doing things that you don't necessarily need a partner for. Giving some lessons towards our solo jazz people out there who don't have a quarantine buddy to dance with.
Yep. And also, of course, as always, these moves can be done with a partner as well, but it can also be done solo. So this week is going to be very footwork focused, in that we will be teaching you the 8-count basic footwork for East Coast Swing instead of the 6-count that we taught you before. And then we'll be teaching you the Charleston, which is really fun.
Yes.
It's one of my favorites.
I love whenever I'm standing, just like,
yeah. Yeah, Jess is always
doing the Charleston.
Charleston, yeah.
Not the 30s, 40s version, though.
Right. So there's actually two versions of the Charleston. There's one that a lot of people see when they hear the Charleston from the 1920s, which is the one that looks like this, one foot in front of the other, and that's the basis for the Charleston. But the one that's most commonly danced today is a different one that looks like this. So we'll be teaching both of those for you today.
Yes.
Okay.
But first, I'm gonna start with 8-count, as Anissa said. 8-count, instead of counting with 6, you count to 8. I feel like that's pretty self-explanatory, but also as a non-math person, in my brain, I kind of focus more on the feeling of the beat than counting to 8 myself, which is okay too.
The basic 8-count swing step is just like our basic 6-count swing step, inverse of each other if you do lead or follow. And it's gonna, instead of having the pattern before of rock, step, 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 or quick, quick, slow, slow, it's gonna have more of that pattern of quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, rock, step, step, rock, step, step. And Jess is gonna demonstrate how the leads do it.
Okay. Leads are opposite from follows. You step back with your left foot first. So obviously you do the rock, step, step. And then with your right foot, you'll rock, step forward. So rock, step, step back. In numbers wise, that's 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 7,
yeah. Yep, you get 8 counts.
And then, adding some triple steps onto it, it's rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step.
So the 8-count basic for the follows is just the inverse of the lead right here. So we're gonna start with our right foot, as always, which is actually this foot for me. And we're gonna do that traditional rock, step with that full weight shift. Rock, step, and then for our next step, another weight shift to step. And then instead of doing the rock step backward like we did before, we're gonna do a rock step forward. Again, switching our legs, rock, step, and then step, coming back to our original position here. So if you look at it, we go right, left, right, left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you still have that momentum because of your weight shift. It's just a lot more linear. And we now have 8 counts. For the 8-count basic, like with the 6-count basic, you also have the triple step version, which for the 8-count basic is probably going to be more common. And that's going to look like rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step. And when you do that triple step, like with the 6-count, you're not shifting your weight each shuffle. You shift your weight towards one way and towards the other. So when you do rock, step, triple step, your momentum's still going forward, and then your weight is still in your right leg. Then you're going to take your left leg, rock, step, triple step. Same thing in that same direction here. Now I'm going to be the follow, Jess is going to be the lead, and we're just going to show you what it looks like together.
5, 6, 7, 8, rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step. And then counting, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
Yep. All right, and when you end, make sure you're always on that opposite leg, or your weight's on the opposite leg, so if it follows, it'd be on our left leg, so that our next step is going to start with our right. And for leads, it's going to be, you end up with your weight on your right leg, so you can start that next step on your left like you're supposed to. Since we did say that you can do it by yourself or with a lead and follow as partners, we'll show you what it looks like with partners real quick.
Okay. Close position?
Close.
Yeah. Okay, so I respectfully put my hand on Mies's back, not too high, because I don't want to lose my,
connection,
and then not too low, because
We're classy here. Yeah. And we're just going to show you it in closed position, but again, you can always do this in open as well. So here's our hands.
Second bit of connection. And then
5, 6, 7, 8. Rock step, triple. Rock step, triple. Rock step, triple. Rock step, triple. Front, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, rock step, triple, rock step, triple.
Wow, full circle.
Full circle, we got the whole angle in there. All right, so we're gonna be teaching you the very basic version of the Charleston that started in the 1920s, or was popularized in the 1920s. And this one, like our basic footwork, both 8 count, 6 count, has a lead and follow. So for leads, we're going to start with our left foot.
So your left foot taps forward, tap it back, like behind, shift your weight, and then tap your right foot behind and bring it back forward. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And if you want to see that from the back,
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah. So with the follows, you're going to be starting with your right foot here. What it's going to look like is tap front, tap back, tap back, tap front. So you get that kind of mirroring effect, and we're going to start with our right foot. We're going to tap front, and then tap back, and then we're going to shift weight, and now with the left, you're going to tap back, and then you're going to tap front. At full speed, it's going to look like tap front, tap back, tap back, tap front, tap front, tap back, tap back, tap front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And then you guys, you see that in the back.
So starting with my right foot, we're gonna start front, tap back, tap back, tap front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
That's it.
Yeah, and that fancy version you're seeing is just adding swivels to that. And what swivels are is that you place your weight on the top front part of your foot, on your toes, and you're gonna just swivel your ankles back and forth. When every time you step and make contact with the floor, you're gonna actually swivel your feet in so that your heels are facing in and your knees are facing out. And then when you bring it out of that and it's in the air, you're gonna bring swivel your feet out, and then when you touch again, you're going to swivel back in. So what that looks like is going to be tap front, tap back, tap back, tap front, tap front, tap back, tap back, tap front, in, out, in, in, out, in, in, out, in, in, out, in. That also translates for the lead. It's gonna be the same motion. Every time you step, you're gonna bring your feet in. If these are your heels and these are your toes, you're gonna bring in and in. Out, in, out, in.
Yeah, we'll show you from the back real quick.
I'm doing the lead and you're doing the follow.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hopefully that helps. I definitely needed a lot of practice to be able to do that. When I first did it, I had my arms kind of flopping around as a chicken to help me really remember when to bring my feet in. But it's not very flattering. I mean, I could do that, but
that's cute. Be a chicken on the dance floor if you'd like to.
Right, so yeah. It takes time, and it's really fun to learn, and also it's kind of like a little cool little flex that you can do to your friends when you're like, oh, I want to see some like cool swing footwork. That's the one.
Okay, so moving forward from that, we also are going to teach you the more commonly seen version of the Charleston, which we showed you before. Okay, so as a lead, doing the Charleston, you start with your left leg and you rock step. As always, very solid move, loyal to a T. And after your weight's shifted, the momentum is gonna wanna keep going forward. So you bring this leg up and kick. And so that together is rock, step, kick. Now, after this foot goes down and you switch your weight from your right to your left leg. So now your right leg is locked and loaded
for the next kick.
Yeah. So you kick forward and you have another kick, which can vary from person to person. It might be a up kick or a side kick. Really just varies per person. So this is like a holding kick, and then you kick back. So that's three kicks on just your right leg. So it would be kick forward, kick like upward, I guess, or however you wanna do it, side, and then kick back. And then finally, after that, you rock onto your right foot so that you can get into the next move. So all together, that'll look like rock, step, kick, shift weights, kick, 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 back again. And do it. If you want to see it from the back, it'd be 5, 6, 7, 8. Rock, step, kick, 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 kick. Okay.
All right. So Jess taught really well for the leads with going step by step. And for the follows, like always, we're gonna be mirroring our leads here. So we're gonna be starting on our right leg. Same thing, we're gonna do that rock step. Right, left. So now your weight is on your left foot, you're gonna bring your right foot, and you're gonna kick out. It doesn't have to be really big. Like we said earlier, we want to keep most of our emotions under our body just for the sake of conserving energy and also having more control, as well as not taking up a lot of space on the dance floor. So we have our kick out. And then when we bring it back, we're going to switch legs right here. So now our weight is on our right. And this time we're going to do three kicks. And that's going to look like kick out, either kick side or kick to up, kick, and then kick back and step. So when you, the chant I like to use throughout all of this is rock, step, kick, and that and is gonna be that switch, kick, 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 step. Rock, step, kick, and kick, 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 step. It does take getting used to, because we usually in our swing dance switch pretty evenly back and forth between our right and left, but this time it's going to be very left heavy or right heavy, depending on whether you're lead or follow.
So the best thing you can do is just keeping that chant in your mind. You're just going to practice it over and over again. And what's really cool about this Charleston is that you can do it. What's really cool about the Charleston is that it's actually to, like, if you listen to the original song, jazz song called the Charleston, it's really, really fast. So you can dance to it to, or you can dance the Charleston to faster songs, and you're not really limited by kind of your body movements for this one. So
yeah.
We're gonna show you what it looks like together. As a follow.
I'll be the lead.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
From the back.
From the back.
Also, I'm the lead again.
And follow.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Rock, step, kick, and kick, 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 step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yep.
All right. So that Charleston you saw here, you can do with a partner, and it's actually really commonly done with a partner in like East Coast swing. So we're gonna just demonstrate what that looks like for you. There's like really cool moves that you can do with a Charleston, but we're just gonna, for the sake of simplicity here, we're just gonna take it slow and just show you what it looks like in partner form.
Okay. So we're gonna get into closed position here. As you can see,
both of our connections are here.
Yeah, very solid. And we're just gonna show you it in closed position. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Kick, 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 step, rock, step, kick, and kick, 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 step. And I'm sorry.
I was just gonna say, I think you were about to say it too. We were not kicking towards each other. We were kicking kind of upwards so that we don't hurt our partner. There's no interference where we're like
battling. Like collision.
Yeah.
We're not playing footsies. Another thing I was gonna say here was that you kind of saw that adjustment. Like Jess was kicking a little bit farther than I was for kicking back. And at that point, I'm gonna make that choice to adjust to her so we're on that same page. And you know, stylistically, it's kind of up to you how big or how small you wanna kick. If there's not enough space, kind of have no choice but to kick small unless you want to be that person in the room. But if you have more space, then it's up to you if you stylistically want to do bigger steps to kind of emphasize and create more dynamic moves, or to keep it small, like maybe to like highlight the very soft music that you're dancing to.
It all depends on the vibe. You know, you read the vibe, you go with it. That's it.
Yeah, and as far as like signaling goes, there's not a really clear signal of how you're supposed, like that we're gonna be going into a Charleston. All that I'm feeling from Jess is that she's going to signal that regular rock step, and if you watch our first video, you know that she's signaling it through her connection back here, where she's rocking back and me keeping my frame, I'm gonna follow her that way. And then, just here, I occasionally look down at Jess's feet to know what move we're gonna be doing. And that's just when I knew to do the Charleston. And you know, if I don't catch on right away, it's not a big deal. I'll catch on immediately, so.
Yeah, you don't really just throw the Charleston in for a second and then, okay, next move. Like, you kind of do it for a while because, I don't know, it takes a while to get into the rhythm with your partner.
Right.
And then usually you do it for like a fun song where you have to express a lot of stamina that way.
Right, and like we said before, that there's different moves that you can do with the Charleston. So, you know, it's not just gonna be like a, it could be
just forward and back line movement of Charleston, or it could eventually be doing something crazy where you're in different directions, or you're going off in the direction opposite.
Or we're doing this thing called tandem, or we're doing it together.
Yeah, and that's, it's just complicated, but right now this is the basics.
This is the basics. And the same thing as the other Charleston that we were teaching you, it is a really fun step to do, and once you master it, you can just kind of pull it out in front of your friends and be like, yo, I got some cool feet movement that I want to show you and flex on. So
yes,
if you're not swinging for swing dance, swing dance for clout.
That's the only way that I was about to say, like, I kind of joined this club for clout. Look at me, vice president.
Wow.
Yes.
All right, that's all we have for today. I hope you had fun with our 8-count footwork thing.
Yes, thank you for coming again. Subscribe if you want to keep up to date with our lessons. We'll be doing this, putting out another video next week. And yeah, thank you for being patient with us in this pandemic. And
let us know
anything we can do to improve or like change our lessons in the comments below. Stay safe, as Misa said.
Stay safe.
Don't get swinging. Corona. Keep swinging.
All right. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Would you like to dance?
Yes, I would like to dance. I'm a lead. Is that okay?
Awesome. I can follow.
Bro, let's see, what else can we do?
Yeah.
I don't know how to do this now.
Yeah, me too. I was like, oh, you're doing it.
I kind of remember it.
It's five.
Watch us get those. Fantastic.